So, three economists play Knosk unter Delis, convinced eBay to run controlled experiments to study the revenue impact of the search engine marketing that eBay conducted with Google. And they were allowed to publish the results in a scientific article, which you can find, which is from 2014. The original data is not available, unfortunately, to replicate this. So this is kind of this business data, marketing data, price data is very, very difficult to get. However, Matt Teddy, who wrote this textbook Business Data Science, which I recommended as background reading for the course if you're interested in it, he has also a lot of exercise in his textbook, and he published a modified version of this data set. So he was allowed to publish this. So it's not the original data, so it was scaled, so some constants were added and also multiplied by some positive number. So we cannot see the original revenues from eBay, but it looks as if the main structure is still there in the data. So we treat this data set as if it would be the original data set when I discuss this forwards, but keep in mind that it's not the original data set. It has been modified for privacy reasons. And so eBay generally used intensively search engine marketing by bidding on different keywords using Google's AdWords platform. However, in the experiment, for 8 weeks following the 22nd of May 2012, eBay stopped search engine marketing in a treatment group of 65 out of 210 so-called designated market areas, which are abbreviated with DMA. So a DMA is kind of a metropolitan area like New York or Los Angeles. And typically, these different DMAs are considered a separated market. And if you type a search term in Google, basically Google guesses from where you're from, possibly based on your IP address, possibly based on your user data if you have registered to Google. So it's not perfect, but possibly doesn't work too badly. And Google allows an advertisement to be regionally targeted. So you can turn on or off your advertiser, for example, for different designated market areas. Okay. And also eBay knows from which market area some user who has bought something comes, because he knows the shipping address of the customer. So that's how you can map basically then the advertisement that you have turned off in some market areas to the effect on the revenues in those market areas. The following plot shows the average revenues per designated market area in the treatment group in blue and in the control group in red. Average basically over all the DMAs for each day. And here on the left, we have basically the period before the experiment had started. So then some data is missing in May. And here from June until 22nd of July, I think, we have the data during the experiment. Again, for the control group where search marketing was still on, and for the treatment group where search marketing was turned off. And first, make a guess. Looking at this data, would you guess that the treatment and control groups, the DMAs which were treated, were perfectly randomized, or was this perhaps imperfect randomization when the control and treatment group were chosen?